Hello all and welcome to another edition of Forcing the Will with Killer Owen, and today I'm going to be covering the Reveillark deck, so let's just jump right on in. We have 20 lands, 3 Ancient Tombs, just a Mana Accelerator just to help us to get out some of our bigger spells like Pattern of Rebirth and Natural Order faster. We have our dual lands. We run 1 Savanna, 1 Scrubland, 2 Bayous, just to give us a good mix of our 3 main colors. I have considered throwing in a Taiga in for the Mog Fanatic instead of having the Wob Cantor, but this list has been doing fine for me, so I decided not to add the Taiga. Gaia's Cradle, just to add a bunch of mana once we have some of our Dryad Arbors and Birds of Paradise out on the battlefield. That way we can just ramp up and play one of our big spells just faster, or if we need to, hard cast the Protean Hulk. We have a Phyrexian Tower. This is just another sacrifice outlet. I'll go over that later with our Protean Hulk combo. Also, our Pattern of Rebirth combo. We have 1 basic forest. Not sure that I really like this, especially against, you know, a format with a bunch of wastelands. I tend to like more basic lands, but it's been doing decent for me. We have 4 fetch lands just to get any combination of the dual lands we need. Also, they all can get a basic forest. So we have 4 Misty Rainforest and 4 Verdant Catacombs. We have 2 Dryad Arbors, which has a great interaction with Green Sun Zenna, since we can just pay the 1 green and choose X for 0. That way, turn 1, we actually have 2 lands in play. Right here, we have Jataxian Probe, just so we can look at our player's hand and just dig deeper into our library. We can cast it for free as well, so that's a big plus. That also has a nice little interaction with Cable Therapy here, just to help us, you know, see what's in our opponent's hand, and that way we can name any of the cards that we want to get rid of. Cable Therapy also helps us get rid of any cards that we have in our hand for our Reveillark combo. Say we have Reveillark or Body Double in our hand, we can Cable Therapy ourselves and discard one of these 2 cards, so it's useful in that way. Here is all of our mana accelerated creatures. 1 Wall of Roots, this is just useful versus the aggro decks mostly. Being a big body and being able to add mana is a huge plus. 4 Birds of Paradise, just a nice mana fixer. It's cheap as well, and it can block flying creatures if we need to. And 2 Tinder Walls, again, another defender. Also gives us red mana if we need to play our Mog Fanatic. So that's those guys. Over here is part of our combo pieces. Here is the Natural Order combo. So yeah, Reveillark is just not the Reveillark deck. It's also a Natural Order deck and a Pattern of Rebirth deck. So there's like 3 pretty much different combos. So the Natural Order combo, obviously we can, depending on the situation, if we have a sacrifice creature on the field, we can just get Protean Hulk and just win right there. Okay, thank you. Go away. It always does this when I do the deck text. I don't know why. So yeah, if we have a sacrifice outlet, we can go get our Protean Hulk. Otherwise, we can just go get Progenitus if we just want to try to win in 2 turns and just race our opponents that way. We have 4 Pattern of Rebirth. We can, if we don't have Natural Order, we can basically just play this on one of our creatures, and hopefully we'll have a sacrifice outlet, one of the many that we have, and we can get sacrifice the creature that this is attached to, and once again we can either get our Protean Hulks or our Progenitus depending on the situation. We have 1 Academy Reactor. This will just help us get out another Pattern of Rebirth. I like to just run one of these. She has her uses. She actually has won me a few games when I've been playtesting this deck. So that is kind of our combo piecers. This is the Reveillark combo. So basically what we'll do is we'll usually end up sacrificing a Protean Hulk, and we will go fetch Body Double, and usually one of the creatures that we can use to sacrifice. We have Risalka here, but Carrion Feeder and Seer are better just because we don't have to pay any mana to activate the sacrifice ability. And so once we get those out in the field, we also usually will get our Dryad Arbor since they don't cost any mana. So Protean Hulk lets us get up to a total of converted mana cost 6 worth of creatures on the battlefield, so Dryad Arbors cost nothing. So once that happens, Body Double comes into play, and we will obviously target Protean Hulk, and then we'll use one of the sacrifice outlets to kill the Body Double, which will trigger the Protean Hulk's ability once again, and this time we will get Reveillark and Mog Fanatic, and from there we sacrifice Mog Fanatic, and ping our opponent for 1 damage. Then we will sacrifice the Reveillark with one of our outlets, and then we'll bring back Body Double and Mog Fanatic, and the process just repeats from there. Just these 3 over and over again until we basically ping our opponent to death. So we have 2 Protean Hulk, just basically explained what that does. And we have 3 sacrificing creatures. So I prefer Carrion Feeder the most just because, worst case scenario, he becomes a huge creature. We also have Seer, which will allow us to scry 1 and just let us alter our library. And Star Brusalka, which can help against some of the burn decks and aggro decks. This is the least useful of the 3, but nonetheless, it is still useful. Here we have some of our specialty creatures. We have 1 Exanted Swarm. This is just going to be useful against mostly the Storm decks or any decks that are running counters, more so the counters. It's also good against certain decks with removal, so if our opponent has removal and they haven't played on our Swarm, we can attack with our Swarm here and prevent them from killing any creature we might play and hopefully combo off that turn. We have 1 Wild Cantor, again, just for mana ramp and also color fixing, mostly for the Mog Fanatic, and 1 Fauna Shaman. This is just going to allow us to get rid of any useless creatures in our hand and tutor up a creature that we need to basically win. We have 4 Green Sun Zenith. Typically, I'll play this turn 1 and go fetch another Dryad Arbor. Late game, I might get a Wild Roots to help against certain aggro decks or even Protean Hulk if we need to win. Just depends on what needs and when we have this in our hand. We have 1 Progenitus, as I stated earlier, for our Natural Order and Pattern of Rebirth combos. So that is basically the main concept of the Reveillark deck. Moving to our sideboard here, we have 4 Leyline of the Voids, most useful against Dredge decks, also against Agrolome, and also other Reveillark decks. Probably won't see another Reveillark deck if you're playing it, but yeah, it happens sometimes, so I'll bring this in against any cards that are going to be abusing the graveyard. 1 Sylvan Library, I usually bring this in if I'm having trouble beating a deck. Dark Horizons, Control decks, just any deck that we're facing where it would benefit us to be able to just dig deeper into our library and maybe get a few extra cards, just help speed up the combo process. We have 3 Carpet of Flowers. We're going to bring this in against basically any blue main deck. This is just going to give us extra mana so that we can combo out faster and have less chance of getting our spells countered. Here we have Artifact Enchantment Removal, depending on what our opponent's board in versus our deck. Most time it's going to be used for Leyline of the Voids or Relic of Progenitus or Tormod's Crypt. 1 Krosan Grip, just because it has split second, so it can't be countered. And I also run 1 Pride Mage. I usually board these 2 in together. The reason I have 1 Pride Mage is because I'm able to tutor it up with Fauna Shaman or Green Sun Zenith if I need to. 1 extra Swarm, already covered that in the main deck, so no need to go over that. And also 2 Slaughter Packs. This is just a good way to get rid of any pesky creatures that our opponent might have, and it also allows us to use it on our own creatures, such as Protean Hulk. So it has a double use there, especially if our opponent has, say, Gaddock Teague on the field, and we need to play Natural Order or Pattern of Rebirth or even Green Sun Zenith. We can Slaughter Pact and go off the same turn without having to worry about having enough mana to pay for everything. Also, we have two Go for Throats, probably one of the best removal spells ever. Destroy target non-artifact creatures, so basically any aggro or creature-oriented deck we can board this in. Obviously, it's not going to do any good against Affinity, but that goes without saying. Once again, much like Slaughter Pact, we can also use this on our own Protean Hulk. So you have it. There's the Reveillark deck and the sideboard I chose to run. And I'm going to do some tournament practice room games since not a single Legacy Daily event has fired in the past week. So I hope you guys can enjoy these videos. I'll see you guys all in game one. Thanks for watching.